I've already shuffled, and we'll be taking a look at the recent past energy between you and the person that you're currently dealing with. We'll see what's coming up for the two of you. We'll find out what the challenge is going to be, and then we'll take a look and see what the outcome is. So, Gemini, the recent past energy between you and your person, well, we've got the Seven of Cups, and it's with the Queen of Cups. Now, the Seven of Cups is the card that's above the word past. Now, this can indicate confusion. It can indicate disorganization. It can indicate having too much going on. And this could have been how your person was viewed. They were viewing you this way. Yeah, this person could have thought that you had a lot of options. You kept the door open to other people. Or for some of you, they felt like you were just way too busy for them. But for most of you, Geminis, your person, they thought that you had a lot of options. They thought you were seeing a lot of other people. This person had a lot of emotions for you because the Queen of Cups is here. The Queen of Cups, that's a card that's below the word pass. Queen of Cups is a very healing, nurturing, and supportive type of energy. And she comes bringing love. What's in the Queen of Cups? Cup is love. So this person had a lot of feelings for you, a lot of emotions. But they felt like you were either too busy for them, or you gave them the impression that you were seeing a whole lot of other people. But let's move on over and let's take a look and see what's coming up for the two of you. So we got the Ace of Wands, and it's with the Nine of Wands. So, Ace of Wands, that's the card above the word present. Well, Ace of Wands, whenever you hear the word ace in the tarot, that does indicate new beginning. The Ace of Wands, it's a wand, so it's about passion. It can be about passion. So, you could be reaching out to this person, wanting a new beginning with them. You could be reaching out to them with a lot of passion, wanting a fresh new start. But it looks like this person, they might build a wall, and they may not let you come towards them, because the Nine of Wands is here, the card that's below the word present. The Nine of Wands is about anxiety and worry. And building a wall, not letting anyone come past your barricade. Yeah, this person, they're not sure about you, Gemini. They think you, I don't know, they think you're just, maybe they think you're just kind of all over the place, because I'm just looking at all those cups there, Seven of Cups. They're kind of scattered all over the place. Yeah, so they're building a wall. You could be wanting a fresh new start with this person. And for some of you, they want a new beginning with you, but they're not going towards you. And they're not letting you in. Yeah. But the thing is, the Queen of Cups is here. So, you've got emotions for this person, but they're not letting you in. So I'm getting that this is you reaching out, wanting a new beginning with this person. But that's what's coming up. So let's move on over. Let's take a look and see what the challenge is. We got the Ace of Swords, and it's with the Three of Wands. Now, like I said, whenever you hear the word ace in the tarot, that's about new beginnings. Now, this Ace of Swords, it's a new beginning, but it's a little bit different. The new beginning gets started by some type of separation. Could be from a neighborhood, a job, a situation, or a person, or something. Some type of separation, some type of cutting out. And then the new beginning takes place. Now, this Ace of Swords is with the Three of Wands. The Three of Wands can be about waiting. It can be about waiting and then eventually you feel like your ship has come in and you're going forward, because the Three of Wands is no longer actually trying to decide. It's made a decision. Or you've made a decision and you're going forward with expansion and growth, feeling like your ship has finally arrived. So that's what the Three of Wands is about. That's the card that's below the word challenge. So what I'm getting here, Gemini, is that your person, this person who's building a wall, they could be waiting. I'm getting that this person is waiting for you to get rid of some of your options, or waiting for you to show them that you're not so busy, because being that they feel like you're like the Seven of Cups, this could make them feel like a lot of times you don't put them on your priority list. They could feel like you're just too busy for them. And like I said, for some of you, they think you keep a lot of options. So they could be waiting for you to change, or to show them that you're making them a priority. You're putting them on the priority list, because this person, they do want to go forward with you. They do want a new beginning with you, but they're waiting for you to cut other people out, or other things in your life out that make them feel like they are just another option for you. Or you make them feel like they're not a priority for you. So they're waiting for you to change, for the connection to change, because they do want this. Yes, they do. Ace of Swords is ready for a new beginning, but they're waiting for you to cut out all these options they think you have, or just cut out being so busy. So we move on over and we take a look and see what the outcome is. Okay, so we got the Sun card, and it's with the Two of Wands. Well, yeah, Two of Wands, that's a card that's below the word outcome. The Two of Wands is actually trying to decide. Yeah, you are not ready to make a decision, Gemini. You are not ready to make a decision. We got the Sun card here. Sun card is about being happy, adding happiness and joy to your life, or someone could be making you really happy. So you're not ready to choose. You're not ready to stop being so busy. You're not ready to cut out your options. But this is what your person is waiting for you to do. Because the Two of Wands is about trying to decide, because you have a couple of options towards the future. Now, what I'm getting is that one of these options make you really happy. One of them. And the other option, you've just got your hand tied to it. So you're trying to decide what to do. Yeah. And your person is waiting. You got someone waiting for you to change. Or waiting for you to choose them. But you got your hand tied to something that really makes you happy. If it's not one of your options, it could be a situation. And you can't really give in to what, you can't really give in to the person that's waiting. Not yet. Because there's something you're doing or someone that you're with, other than this person, that makes you really happy. So that is the reading that I have for you, Gemini. I hope you enjoy the reading. I hope it resonates. As you know, general readings, they do not resonate with everyone. Then again, if you like the reading, please comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell. That way you'll be notified when I post my next reading. I will also put a link below of the extended of this reading, where I'll go over how you both feel about the situation, what's in the near future for the two of you, how you see yourself, best case scenario, and what will happen between the two of you in the next few weeks. There's also a link below for personal readings if you'd like to try one of those. So Gemini, thank you so much for watching. I hope all of you are doing well and staying safe during this crazy virus season. Yep, hang in there. It's all going to pass and we'll get through this. So stay strong. Take good care. I hope you guys come back and join me for the next Gemini reading. Just in case this one did not resonate, maybe the next one will. Also, keep in mind the roles of the people can be switched, meaning you could be them or they could be you. And if you're not dealing with anyone romantically, the other person could actually be a friend, a family member, a coworker, or a situation. So just take the reading for however it resonates, because once again, these are general readings, they're not personal readings. So Gemini, I can never say it enough. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a great day. I hope to see you at the next reading, and take care.